Good afternoon, students. After having studied all the previous seminars in the category of wires, metal sheet, and other cheap antennas, today we are going to have a special type of antenna that we call reflector antennas. So, as name suggests, it shows that somewhere just the basic principle of this antenna depends on some reflecting property. So, this antenna is really function on the principle of reflection. That is also part of the optics. Optics says that if any ray is coming from focal point of any surface, the surface is supposed in parabolic shape or any other shape, then it will get reflected back. So particularly in this type of antenna, we are using the principle of optics, and as the design part is concerned, we are taking one metal sheet. And metal sheet we are folding in the parabolic shape, because if you are not folding, then after reflection you will not get the reflected power in the particular directions. So introduction part, you can see that as all the antennas need feed, then only it will radiate certain energy. So specialty of this antenna is not directly fed. It has been fed by some other antenna. And that antenna should be situated at the focal of this parabolic shape. So because this antenna which is used for the feeding is the only main component, that's why this feeding antenna is also called active antenna. So this active antenna generally we take hard antenna, because hard antenna have additional directivity, So that it means that if you are using feed itself which is high directivity now, and it is related particular reaction in particular direction, so after reflection also as a result will get the further improvement in the directivity. And in this hard antenna generally radiate spherical waves. So spherical waves are coming from this feed antenna and striking on the inner surface of this reflector, and yet after reflection we are getting this spherical wave converted into plane wave. This wave, resultant wave, is going to be plane wave. So we can also say that this reflector antenna is one of the antenna which converts any spherical wave into plane wave, and as a result we get the better directivity. So because of this high directivity antenna, we use antenna in very particular cases. So I will move to applications. Because of this high directivity, this antenna is mostly used in long distance point to point communication. In addition, because of this property, this antenna is also used in radar and also in our TV receivers. So far we have seen this antenna offers better directivity. Because of the directivity, we are getting particular three applications. As far as feeding is concerned, I have already mentioned that feed we take the hard antenna, which is again a very directive antenna. Now design. As far as design is concerned, it is very important parameter. Without having proper design, you cannot have any particular antenna for particular purpose. So if you see the feeder diagram of this antenna, only feed parameters are need to be designed. The first one is, what is going to be aperture of this parabolic shape? That is one parameter. And second one, what is the distance between this focal point and to the surface of reflector? So that is, these two parameters are very important as the design is concerned. So there is a relation between these two parameters. This says that the ratio of focal length to the aperture of reflector should be related by this formula f by d equal to 0.25 cos theta by 2. So where f is focal length is the aperture and theta is angle at which this primary antenna putting out or transmitting the energy and falling inside the inner surface of the reflector. So this is only one design parameter which is very useful, and having this parameter we can estimate the design parameter, and this is also known as aperture number. As for performance question, I have already mentioned that it is very high directivity antenna. So these are all about the reflector antenna. So in next class we will take the further antennas. Thank you.